Hello everyone, thanks for tuning in again. We're going to go through another episode of new smart home products and new home automation features here for you right after this. The first thing I'm going to talk to you about this week is called Amazon Key. Now that's a service that was produced by Amazon actually last year, and when they announced that service, it was intended as an opportunity for you as someone ordering off of Amazon to open up your home when you know there's an Amazon parcel arriving, and that allows the Amazon delivery person to drop that parcel inside your home. Now what Amazon has done recently is they've actually opened this up to being able to deliver to your vehicle. Now this is only possible if you have a certain model of vehicle. We're talking 2015 and greater Chevrolets with an OnStar service, or a Volvo, again 2015 or greater, and the Volvo on-call service there. You have to be signed up for one of those two things and have that vehicle be newer than the 2015 model, or the 2015 model or newer. If you're like me, you've been using the Google Play Music service for a long time. The reason I started using Google Play Music was actually the capability of uploading my entire library of music and then having it be cloud-based. So this gave me the opportunity to put all my music somewhere and not have to pay for that. Now, of course, I went ahead, I started paying for the service because I wanted access to their entire library of music. However, it's sounding like YouTube Remix is a new service. It's a new service that will be coming out here right away from Google, and it will be replacing Google Play Music. And I think we've seen the writing on the wall a little bit for the entire Google Play ecosystem or set of applications here. It just seems like those are not being carried through, and a service like YouTube Remix sounds like the next evolution. I want to tell you about a new product. This is something that, again, you can go and find on Kickstarter. So we're seeing some of these technology type of inventions or products coming out on Kickstarter, and they're fairly serious products. So what I want to talk to you about today is called Speak Easy by Como Audio, and this speaker has the Google Assistant on board. What's more is it can actually be a portable speaker and can be used for multi-room audio along with your Google Assistant. Now what Como Audio has actually come out and said you'll need to do is go buy a Chromecast audio in order to create that multi-room audio. They've just ensured that the right port is there for you to use with their speaker. This next story is a little relatable for me as someone who's a computer engineer and who completed a number of, you know, these product development type projects throughout school and in order to get my engineering degree. Now, what's come out from a university and also from Disney Research is actually a wall, and they're calling it Wall Plus Plus. Now, Wall Plus Plus, they're saying it costs about $20 per foot in terms of materials, and then the wall is actually physically connected to a control board. So Wall Plus Plus, it's essentially capable of reading movement, sensing electromagnetic or electronics in a room just based on fields, magnetic fields, electromagnetic fields coming off the wall, and it's even able to sense you as a person. It would be able to do even better if you were a person wearing sensors. Now, this is still in a research stage, but I think it's pretty easy to see just from the demo, and I'll leave a link down below for you to go watch this video. You can see from their demo that it's going to be capable of doing a lot of the sensing that we've talked about in the past, actually, with, you know, Roomba saying, hey, we can travel around your home, map what you're doing, map what type of devices you have around your home. This Wall Plus Plus is capable of doing that with objects, with people, with objects being turned on like lights. And so its applications appear to be endless to me. So this is a great video for you to go watch here at the end of our video. One of the things that I've been watching a lot is the If This Then That platform. Now, they've had a number of opportunities to go out and get funding from different sources, but they have yet to really produce a full, complete business model that's allowing them to go out and make money in order to keep the platform alive. And I think this is a big risk to us as, you know, smart home people or home automation people, because this platform ultimately allows you to connect almost everything. Recently, If This Then That has actually come out, and they're now talking about helping what they're calling legacy companies, or companies that just don't have a smart home product or don't really have a automation type of focus. They want to help those companies connect to basically this smart world or the Internet of Things. And so that would allow them to pull money out of those companies in order to connect them and partner with them to do this. And so this is a model that they can go ahead and use for going forward to produce revenue and therefore to keep the service free for the users like you and I. I don't talk a lot about Chinese manufacturers of smart home equipment. There's just not a lot out there that I think has the functionality that you and I are looking for, and really just not that deep enough automation functionality yet. However, the tides are starting to change or turn, and I want to tell you about Xiaomi and their Akara series of products. This is a series of products that they've recently announced. Now, the Akara series has a light bulb, a cube controller, a smart door lock, and that door lock actually has a fingerprint sensor. Now, what they've come out and announced is that they're going to have HomeKit capability in the very near future. On top of that, they're talking by the end of 2015 to actually have the capability of connecting with both the Google Assistant and Amazon Alexa or Echo device. The last thing I want to talk about this week is in relation to Sonos. Now, I could talk to you a little bit about Sonos offering updates and letting you go to AirPlay 2, and you know, that's good stuff, don't get me wrong. But what I want to talk about this week is actually the fact that Sonos has filed for a smart home theater speaker. And it would have on board an HDMI port. So this much we know. What we also think from the filing, or what it seems to be from the filing, is a smart home speaker with an onboard voice assistant. So I imagine this is going to look a lot like a Sonos One. And hopefully in this case, it has both of the voice enabled assistants on board, like we've been coming to expect from the Sonos One. So there you have it. That's our video for this week related to smart home products, your home automation features, all those new things that are out there this week. I hope this has helped you out. And if it has, of course, there's a subscribe button coming at the end of this video. So thanks for watching, everyone. We'll see you next time.